is a presentation of Fox Sports.
We are Fox Sports. We are Sun.
Last night, the Rays seemed to be cruising to victory with a 5-run lead over Detroit heading into the ninth. But the Tigers rallied for 8 runs, pulling off the improbable 10-7 comeback win. Tonight, left-hander Drew Smyly goes to the hill, looking to get the Rays back on the winning track. Tonight at Tropicana Field, the Rays continue their longest home stand of the year, an 11-gamer, and this will be game 2 of a 4-game series between the Rays and the Detroit Tigers. Hi again, everyone, and welcome to an evening of Rays baseball with Brian Anderson, Dwayne Statz. Great to have you aboard. Well, last night, Paul Tanner sang the national anthem here. He was good enough to offer me his performance jacket in hopes of getting the Rays off to a good start in July, because BA, they certainly did suffer in June, finishing the year in an ignominious fashion last night. But one guy who had a great month of June was their third baseman, Evan Longoria.
And before we get to that, I will take you up on that offer, and we're going out after the game tonight.
You got it, buddy.
With that jacket, we have to. Yeah, you're right about Evan Longoria. This is one guy, and typically you look at it, and as Evan Longoria goes, the Rays go with him. That was not the case, because in the month of June, Evan Longoria, 324 average, 17 extra base hits. He hit safely in 22 of 26 games. He had 8 multi-hit games, including 3 of the last 4. The hands are quick, the swing is smooth, the plate coverage is outstanding, and he's handling mistakes right now. You leave it out over the plate, he is hurting you big time. And tonight he's gonna go up as the rest of that Rays lineup against Michael Fulmer, and they kind of got him hot. You go back to the Rays start back in May and what he's done since then, a 5-1 record, the ERA of 0.61. He's given up just 3 earned runs in 44 and a third innings. Has tremendous stuff, attacks the strike zone, and the numbers speak for themselves. The Rays offense will have their hands full tonight.
Well, a tough outing last night for the Rays, and Erasmo Ramirez wondering about the fatigue factor. And when we come back, Todd Callis takes an up close look at just that.
For the Rays, taking on the Tigers, Drew's former team. The Rays could use innings out of Smiley. The bullpen has been used often this year. And one guy in particular, Erasmo Ramirez, has 21 appearances of four outs or more. That's the most in Major League Baseball. Erasmo started out as really the team MVP for the first 5 or 6 weeks. As we look at our Coors Light cold hard facts, you'll see that Erasmo, first dozen games, 1.13 ERA, chewing up innings, 5-1 record in those 24 innings. One of those games was as a starter. Last 21, though, has not been good. A 7.16 earned run average during that time. Kevin Cash knows very well about the overusage of Erasmo and finding some spots for him to get a breather.
We're constantly are always talking about that, and we know the benefit of it. It is very difficult to do right now because we're at the same time we're trying to win ball games, and we know that he's a huge part of that.
At one point, Erasmo was on pace for 110 relief innings. He's now on a pace for about 95, so they have lessened his load more recently, hopefully to get that turned around for a guy who was so dominant early in the season. We're ready for baseball. Rays and the Tigers next on Fox Sports Sun.
Rays left-hander Drew Smiley goes to the mound tonight against his former teammates, the Detroit Tigers, in the same matchup as in Detroit on May the 21st, Smiley against Michael Fulmer. Here is the starting lineup for Detroit, presented by your Southern Ford dealers. Ian Kinsler will again lead off, followed by Cameron Maben. Miguel Cabrera hits third. Victor Martinez, the DH. The Castellanos at third base. Justin Upton hits sixth, plays left field. Mike Aviles in the game in right field, hitting seventh. In front of James McCann, the catcher. And Jose Iglesias, the shortstop, again batting ninth.
Well, taking the mound tonight for the Tampa Bay Rays is going to be left-hander Drew Smiley, making his 16th start of the season and looking to get back into the win column. It's been since May the 16th that Drew has been able to do that. He's going up against his old team. Motion's always running high in a game like this, so how he settles in early, and if he can get those pitches in the zone and then expand from there, he should be just fine. Let's take a look at that defense and see how it's going to line up behind him tonight. Brought to you by Gold and Diamond Source. In that outfield left to right, we have Nick Franklin, Brandon Guyer, and Oswaldo Arcia. And across the infield, third to first, Evan Longoria, Brad Miller, Logan Forsythe, and Logan Morrison with Hank Conger back behind the plate.
Well, Drew Smyly set to go to work. It's been a difficult run for Drew over the last seven starts. He's lost four of those decisions, 0-4 in that stretch. And set to go to work tonight against the Tigers and their second baseman, Ian Kinsler. First pitch of this game, a ball up and away, so we're underway tonight. Kinsler hitting .295 overall and .360 against left-handed pitching this year, sixth in the American League in that category. There's a strike on the outside part of the plate. 2-1.
Boy, good numbers across the board, even against the righties. And one of the more aggressive leadoff hitters that you will find. He really, big swing. He's got power.
Yeah, considerable pop in that bat for Kinsler.
There's that uppercut swing where he's able to generate, try to get that ball in the air. But, you know, as he's aged and matured as a player, smarter and smarter. Situational hitting.
That's a strike. Now it's 3-2. And he's 5-13 against Smyly. So Drew, careful with him right from the beginning. 3-2 pitch. He got it. Cut the miss. He went away and got him to chase. Strikeout number one and out number one.
Well, there was that uppercut swing. You say stay behind the fastball, drive it to the corner, and that swing just is never able to get up to that pitch. And that pitch wasn't even really elevated. Well located, though, just off the edge, too close to take. And Kinsler right there, not able to get it.
Now Cameron Maben. Maben up in the number two spot in this series, and he takes a strike. Maben had a big hit last night. You can see his numbers against the Rays. He came off the disabled list when the Rays were in Detroit early in the month. And boy, did he come off hot and has stayed that way, hitting .359 for the year. Pops it up. Right side, that ball will carry just out of play.
You know, this is a big one, Wayne, and I'm going to tell you, a great job by Maben. The changeup that's down, you see how he changed his swing to get that ball in the air. The Rays had pulled the infield in, and Erasmo Ramirez is going for the changeup, trying to get the ground ball, and he changed his whole swing plane to stay back and try to elevate that ball, get it into the outfield at minimum. And it turns out to be a bases-clearing double, and that was the difference in the game.
Another pop foul that will carry out of play.
If he takes his normal swing at that pitch, he hits the ball right into the ground. It was not a bad pitch, but he was able to get underneath it, and that's what was so impressive about it. Almost as impressive as that necklace. Almost.
And he went after that one out on strikes. He leaves the plate area. And so that's out number two.
Good off-speed delivery there by Drew. Looked to be the curveball straight into the ground. And because of his arm angle, when he spins that pitch, it's straight up and down. 12-6 style, and Maben can't hold up.
Miguel Cabrera. Cabrera starts the night at .299. 1-for-5 in the game last night. Pitch just off the plate. 1-0. Scott Berry calling the balls and strikes. Young umpire out of Battle Creek, Michigan. not unlike Adam Hamari, who worked the plate last night, not all that fond of giving the pitch in the upper region of the strike zone, but from time to time will work the corners with the pitcher a little bit. This one outside. So it's 3-0 here to Cabrera. And ball four, a four-pitch walk after two strikeouts to start the game.
Well, you fall behind a guy like Miguel Cabrera, and then you play it safe. I mean, you're just not going to give in to him, so you continue to work the edges, try to get him to maybe get a little bit too aggressive, and he's just much too disciplined a hitter to do that.
And Smiley has to be sensitive to the long ball. He's given up 19 home runs this year, third most in the American League behind Chris Young of Kansas City and Jared Weaver of the Angels. Here's Victor Martinez. Pitch down. He wanted that pitch.
You need that pitch.
Yes.
If you're not going to get that pitch, the 3-0 pitch to Miguel Cabrera, if that's going to be a ball, and then the first pitch to Martinez is going to be a ball, where would you like it?
And again, just down, 2-0. That can be frustrating for a pitcher. Two pretty good pitches, actually.
Yeah, that one there, I'll give Scott Barry. The previous one, no excuse. You know, all of a sudden, you're looking at hitting a shoebox. Makes it pretty easy for the hitter.
Into center field. Here comes Guyer, and he makes the catch. Hits the ground as he grabs it and holds on. That will take care of Detroit. No runs, a walk, and a man left. Brandon Guyer on the move to grab that one. Rays coming in to hit, bottom of the first coming up. No score. He's coming in to hit. Let's take a look at Kevin Cash's lineup presented by Southern Ford Dealers. Logan Forsyth, Brad Miller, and Evan Longoria down the middle. Logan Morrison, Brandon Guyer, and Corey Dickerson. Nick Franklin in left. Oswaldo Arcia in right. And Conger, the catcher, hits ninth, all against Michael Fulmer. First pitch is a strike to Forsyth. And BA, when the Rays saw Fulmer in Detroit, he was an impressive young right-hander.
You know, he went into that start, Dwayne. His record 2-1, fine. ERA was over 6.5. Since then, he's given up 3 earned runs in 44 and a third inning. And he does have tremendous stuff. But the one thing that I will say, the one thing that it gives you hope as well as he's been throwing the baseball, because this is the first time in his major league career where he's facing a team for the second time. So he's not sneaking up on the Rays this time. They've seen him. They know what he has. There you go.
So we'll see how that plays out tonight. 0-2 here to Forsythe. And he fouls that one. Logan at 308. A three-hit night last night. A run scored and a run batted in. He continues to be excellent in the leadoff spot. And strikes out. Pitch sharply moving away from him. One gone.
Well, let's take a look at the Detroit Tiger defense and see how it's going to line up behind Michael Fulmer here tonight, brought to you by Golden Diamond Source. And in the outfield left to right, we have Justin Upton, Cameron Maben, and Mike Aviles. Across the infield, third to first, Nick Castellanos, Jose Iglesias, Ian Kinsler, and Miguel Cabrera, with James McCann behind the plate.
Now Brad Miller in there. Bounces one to the right side. Fulmer covers and takes the toss from Cabrera. Well, as the Rays and the Tigers play in the bottom of the first inning here tonight, the Cleveland Indians and the Toronto Blue Jays are getting ready to move into the 19th inning in Toronto. That game is tied 1-1. Cleveland a run on 14 hits, and the Blue Jays a run on 11 hits at the end of 18.
How about Ryan Goins?
Yeah,
went to the mound.
Pitching for the Blue Jays.
He went to the mound in the top of the 18th and had a bases loaded one out situation and got the ground ball double play to get out of it.
So I'm assuming he'll be out there for the 19th.
How do you take him out of the game after that?
That's right. 1-0 the count to Evan Longoria, coming off a great month of June.
How do those two teams play 18, but basically two complete games, and those two offenses have combined for two whole runs? How's that possible?
Trevor Bauer is in there for Cleveland, and Goins now for Toronto. 2-1.
We got a new pitcher, Dwayne. Ryan Goins out. Darwin Barney.
Oh, well.
In.
Wow, after that great job Goins turned in, he's out. Barney's in there. And we're not talking about Barney Schultz.
No, he pitched the eighth and the ninth.
Well, Toronto with pitching depth from their infield. 2-2 now. Did he go? Yes, he did. On the slider, he's out on strikes. Two strikeouts in the first with the slider. Onto the second, no score. program exclusively for Rays seats and ticket holders. Blends hospitality and comfort, offering local craft beers and themed signature food items. It's Tropicana Field's newest destination, exclusively for Rays seats and ticket holders. The Republic Bank Draft Room. Call 888-FAN-RAYS for information. We go to the second. Nick Castellanos leads it off. Drew Smyly's first pitch is a strike at the knees. In that Cleveland-Toronto game, Barney's the 10th pitcher in that game for the Blue Jays. And Carlos Santana has just homered off Barney to make it 2-1 Cleveland. Ground ball. Longoria has this one, and that will take care of Castellanos. Maybe they pull Goins too quickly.
Yeah, well, here's what I'll say, though. You know, position players going to the mound and throwing from that angle, you know, you do it a little bit too much. I mean, you've seen before where guys have gone out just for a mop-up inning, and they end up hurting themselves. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's a different dynamic of, you know, making a play in the field and throwing to first base than getting on the mound. You know they're throwing, you know, pretty max effort, and they're throwing in that downhill plane, something that they are not used to doing at all. So I can understand them not wanting to risk Goins getting hurt, but, yeah, that's tough.
Yep, 2-1 now. Bauer had been in there the last four innings for the Indians. And you know how tough he can be. Strike two here on Justin Upton. Mike Avila's on deck. It's a ball, two strikes. Couple strikeouts in the first inning for Smyly. Ground ball out here to open the second. He's ahead of Upton. And he strikes him out. Fastball. Out number two in the second. Strikeout number three.
Yeah, and both of the strikeouts on the fastball are hitter or pitches that you think these guys are going to be able to get get to. That pitch right there wasn't like it was even elevated. That ball is below the belt. And Justin Upton still pulling off of that pitch, and the big uppercut swing is right underneath it.
Now Avilés takes a strike. Avilés primarily an infielder, but he's in right field tonight.
Taking a page from the Rays playbook.
Well, this one out of play. Boy, that's for sure. And Nick Franklin is in left field for the Rays tonight. We've seen him in right and left. There he is.
Well, you know, you get Brandon Guyer back. All of a sudden in last night's game, Desmond Jennings pulls up with a tight hamstring. They're saying, you know, day to day, we'll see how that goes. But this outfield issue for the Rays is getting kind of old at this point. So unfortunate.
There's Arcia headed toward the line to make the catch on this one. A 1-2-3 second. We are through an inning and a half. No score. second inning. Rays and the Tigers in the second game of the series. The Toyota keys to success for Michael Fulmer. The success came early. 11 starts, he's 7-2, and had to settle in a little bit. Look at the last seven starts, 5-1 with an 0.61 ERA. Pitch to Logan Morrison is a strike. They got him from the New York Mets organization in the Cespedes deal. And he'd had a couple minor league seasons with a shoulder problem and an elbow problem, had bone spurs in the elbow. And then had come back and was pitching well in the minor leagues when they made that deal. The Tigers appear to have something special here in Michael Fulmer.
And the key for them now moving forward is managing his innings. You know, this start here, this is his eighth day. So first you wonder how sharp he will be, because it's been an extended period of time. He'll take his next turn in the middle of next week, but then not until, you know, the fifth spot is needed after the All-Star break as a way to try to manage his innings. They'd like to keep him in that 160, 165 inning range. And so that will be the challenge for the Tigers, is to parse out those starts so that they, you know, he stays in that range they want him in.
Well, he was pitching at the A and double A level in 2014. It's a ground ball on the right side there, and Morrison is out of there. Castellanos over from third had moved into short right field out of the shift. He pitched a little under 100 innings in 2014 and came up with a shoulder strain. And then the next year with the bone spur, came back from that and was pitching pretty well in the minor leagues and the New York Mets system when they made that deal. And the Tigers very careful with him now, because they certainly like what they've seen from him. Brandon Guyer, ball one. Pitch in the mid-90s right there. See that sharp slider and then that great fastball.
And the changeup, really not a bad option either. Three very good pitches from Fulmer. You know, the one thing that you could say about him is he had 24 walks and 63 2/3. Not terrible, about 3.5 per 9. That's really the only knock on him so far this year. He keeps the ball in the yard. He gave up the two home runs in the last, you know, well, last 45 plus innings. And he's got good stuff. You see right there, the late break.
And he just missed on that one. And no chase from Guyer. You saw that slider he threw to Longoria to get him to end the first. That was impressive. Guyer fouls one away. Well, it's a final in Toronto, and the Indians beat the Blue Jays in 19, 2-1.
Wow. And that was on Canada Day. That's a big day up there.
Mm-hmm. Rays have been up there a time or two for Canada Day. Now 3-2 to Guyer. See another 3-2 pitch. Fulmer retiring the first four. Bottom of the second inning, scoreless. A swing and a miss. He powers that one by him. Mid-90s fastball.
Yeah, that's early in the game, full count. I'm done messing around. I'm just going to power a fastball and see where it takes me. And he throws that ball right down the middle. But that late life, late action, that little jump gets right over the bat and the swing of Guyer.
Corey Dickerson. Dickerson starts the night with 13 home runs and a 214 average. Let's it go on that fastball and misses. Strike one. Back the other way. Foul. 0-2. Ground ball back over the middle, past the mound and through into center. Dickerson has a base hit. The Rays collect their first hit. First base runner
tries to go up in the zone, and Corey Dickerson able to get up to that pitch. Number one, I think the bat may be done, but he finds a hole up the middle, keeps his inning alive.
Brings up Nick Franklin, who suddenly has 9 runs batted in 4 games. He's made 3 starts, hitting 250. And he puts down a bunt that's going to roll foul. Strike one, trying to bunt his way on.
Well, it was open. It was open for him, that's for sure. And if he's successful, now you're talking worst case scenario, first and second, a runner in scoring position. So you take that chance and
get a power bat to the plate at Arcia,
yep,
who's on deck. One. Rays 1-3 on the year against the Tigers. Up 2 out of 3 to them in Detroit. In on him. That fastball in, and he fouls it.
You're able to get a fastball in like that with that swing, you know that Nick Franklin is now thinking, I've got to be a little quicker. That pitch serves so many different purposes. Number one, to get a strike, but then you put that in a hitter's head, you can go slider down and in. It opens up the outer part of the plate.
Fouls this one. Still 1-2.
You try to go with that slider with the thinking, just got him sped up in there with the fastball. Come with the off-speed pitch, he's going to have to react quick. And then if my slider has depth, and that's the key to that pitch, if it has depth, now it dives underneath the swing. That one didn't have as much depth. Nick Franklin able to foul it off and live to see another one.
And he's out on strikes. Oh. Well, and then he breaks out the changeup. We're at the end of 2, no score.
6.5 hours in Toronto, Ontario, Canada on Canada Day. Chris Jimenez grounds into a double play with the bases loaded and one out in the eighth inning against Ryan Goins. Goins did not play in this game except for as a pitcher. Then Darwin Barney comes in. Mid-80s fastball in the outer half. And Carlos Santana drives it over the wall to break the 1-1 tie. And then it was Trevor Bauer, the starter, who came in out of the bullpen and threw 83 pitches in five shutout innings. 2-1 the final. The Indians have won 14 in a row. Both teams, guys, used pitchers that combined for a total of over 300 pitches in that crazy game today in Canada.
Boy, crazy is right. And the Indians come out with a win again. Well, here we're in the third. James McCann, a fellow Razorback here, facing Drew Smyly. It's 1-2. McCann with a couple of key home runs over the last couple of years against Smyly. And they were teammates at Arkansas in college baseball. Into the dirt. He went around on the appeal. Trip Gibson down there at first. Says he's out of there. McCann not real happy with that call.
Yeah, we'll have to take a look at that. But James McCann had ball down in the dirt. The swing starts. Does it hold up? Probably does, but the call does not go his way.
So that's four strikeouts for Smyly. Fulmer has four through the first two for Detroit. Jose Iglesias fouls it back. There's a strike. He's hitting 257. Tigers in with a three-game winning streak, and they've moved three games over 500, running third in the Central. Started the day 7.5 back. Brad Ausmus, their manager, third year.
Well, with the Indians doing what they're continuing to do, they're eight back now.
Yeah, tough to make any ground up in the Central with the pace the Indians are setting.
That's a run that teams will go on, and you distance yourself to the point there's not much anybody else can do about it. You hope to hang around six, seven, eight games back. Indians will eventually lose again. That is going to be assured. But they have certainly put some distance between themselves and Kansas City, Detroit, Chicago.
Three and two. Well, I tell you, I really think the two teams that we've seen that have been impressive have been the San Francisco Giants and the Cleveland Indians. Forsyth at second base will make this play. Iglesias is the second out. The Rays saw Kansas City. The Royals just take it to you as well. But I really think the two teams that have impressed me the most have been the Giants and the Indians.
Yep. Well, that Indians team, you look at the starting pitching, and one through five can give you issues. One of the best rotations in all of baseball, really, when they throw those guys out there. So that gives you a chance every single night. But then the little things. Clutch team, they've got guys that know how to, you know, they've got good defenders out there. Situational hitting, got some veteran leadership. They got all the little different parts, and then you got Terry Francona down there in the dugout, a guy that brings, you know, the instant credibility, been there, done that on a big stage in a big market, and so he's got the ear of all of his players, and you know they're feeding off of that, and they're playing obviously very well now. And the Giants, they just workmen like you to death.
Yep, they certainly do. They play a great brand of baseball, kind of a throwback. They do a lot of things right. They wear you down and don't make a lot of mistakes.
Well, that's such a key too. You know, if you can keep from, you know, you think about the success of the Minnesota Twins for that long run that they had.
Yep.
And they just were a team that you had to beat them. They were not going to make the critical errors, do the dumb things, make the base running gaffes. misplay balls. They weren't going to do that. They were not going to beat themselves. You had to come out there. You weren't going to walk a lot of guys as a pitching staff, give you free base runners. And they were able to translate that into a sustained run of success.
2-2, foul back. Two outs, bases empty. Ian Kinsler at the plate. Smiley got him on a fastball away. A swing and a miss in the first inning, and he's 2-2 with him here in the third. And a cut and a miss. He comes in that time with a fastball on the other side of the plate. We go to the bottom of the third, scoreless. Half of the third, our greater coverage of baseball is brought to you by T-Mobile. A couple of interesting notes. The Orioles in the American League, 56 home runs in June, breaking the previous record of 55 of the 96 A's. Madison Bumgarner got into that lineup in an American League park in Oakland. And that outing against the Oakland A's for the Giants. He agreed he's not going to be part of the home run hitting contest in the All-Star game, but he got into the lineup against the A's.
I wonder how much negotiating went on for that.
Here's Arcia sending one into left, and that's going to be caught by Upton.
Like, you know, I'll stop my public campaign to get into the All-Star home run derby. I'll quiet that down, but I'm pitching in Oakland in the next couple nights. I'm going to be in the lineup.
If indeed that's what happened, that was another good move by Bruce Bochy. That's a sign of a very good manager to let him hit against Oakland and not enter that home run hitting contest at the All-Star game. No upside in that at all.
What did David Ortiz, who is skipping the home run derby, and his reason being it wears you out.
Too strenuous.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's coming from a guy who takes BP every day, all the time.
Well, Hank Conger hits one extremely high, finally caught by Cabrera as it came down. Well, you'd like to see that one about 15 feet off the ground line somewhere. With that kind of distance on it, have a shot. Two outs. There's Logan Forsythe, top of the order for the Rays. And there's a strike. Well, the first time through the order for Fulmer, he gives up one hit, a single to center. by Corey Dickerson. It's fouled up the right side, headed for the seats. Nothing in two. Ball, two strikes. Forsyth checked in time. Went wide there. No offer, and it's 2-2. Brad Miller hoping to get a chance to hit in this inning. To wait till next inning. Strikeout number 5 on the off-speed pitch. We're through 3, no score.
Fourth inning, Drew Smyly was reflecting on his first major league start prior to this one. It came against the Rays as a member of the Tigers in 2012. Through 28 first inning pitches, including walking the leadoff batter Desmond Jennings. After that game, Justin Verlander came up to him and said, "Drew, your stuff is good enough to play at this level. You've got to be more aggressive within the strike zone." And Smyly said ever since then, he keeps that in the back of his mind, that when he is nitpicking or not being aggressive in the zone, that what Justin Verlander told him after that first start has played the rest of his career, guys.
Well, good advice, and we'll see Verlander tomorrow afternoon for Detroit against Blake Snell. It's a 4-10 first pitch. Liner in the center and a base hit for Maben. So Maben picks up the first hit surrendered by Smyly. Maben does is get hits against the Rays.
It was 10 out of 15 coming in. He took a strikeout in his first at bat, immediately repays Drew Smyly with a single to center. So now 11 out of 17 and 8 of his 20 runs batted in.
Yeah, and he's 4 out of 5 against Smyly with a home run.
Do you think he goes in as a Tiger?
If he keeps this up, he certainly will. 1-0 the count. Miguel Cabrera. He was the only base runner given up by Smyly on a first inning walk until Maben's leadoff single. And it gets Cabrera up here with a man on. In on him, and he fouls it. the Rays trying to get off to a good start in the month of July. 11-17 in June. It's the worst June they posted since 2007.
I don't like when those pre-2008 years pop up.
Yeah, not a good trend.
They're popping up a little too frequently.
Yeah, the team ERA was over 5.12. And again, you have to go back to June of 07 to find one that high. 5.79 then in June. So put those away and turn this thing around. Pitching is going to be the key. You know, the bullpen has been worked hard. Rays looking for more quality innings out of the rotation.
That's where it starts. That's where you decrease the workload already.
Runner goes and the pitch is fouled out of play. 1-2. One thing leads to another.
It does. It does. And you know that these guys are fully capable of doing that. You know, they've been last year a lot of times, you know, guys getting pulled out early by design.
Mm-hmm.
This year, you know, Kevin Cash has made it very clear. We need more from our starting rotation as far as innings. Here's a leash. It's longer. Run with it. And if they're able to do that, you will see things turn around. They'll score enough runs, and the bullpen, their work will be limited.
Another good jump. Throw down is high, and a steal. Maben with his ninth stolen base of the year on the strikeout of Cabrera. He picks up a steal and now moves into scoring position. Seventh stolen base with Smiley on the mound this year in 10 attempts.
Boy, that fastball right down the middle. Cabrera misses it. Hank Conger a little bit late on the throw. You see Maben, he's already in his pop-up before this ball gets down there.
So one on, one out. Our Toyota inside look on Victor Martinez, the DH. 14 major league seasons of the Indians, Red Sox, and the Tigers. He's done nothing except hit, hit, and hit again.
Yeah, and as we pointed out last night, from both sides of the plate. I mean, that's the thing that's so impressive, the switch hitter.
Just down, 1-0.
I mean, that's absurd right there.
Yes.
I mean, from both sides. 300's the worst.
Yeah. Well, we talked about him last night from the time he started pro ball. He just rolled from the amateur ranks right into the low minor leagues and started hitting. And hasn't stopped. Two balls, no strikes. Smiley got him on a fly ball to center in the first. First time either team has had a man in scoring position tonight as we play in the top half of the fourth. Three and oh. Inside for the fastball. 27-year-old lefty Drew Smiley. Nick Castellanos is on deck. There's a strike, 3-1. Looking for his first win at home this year. He's 0-4 here at the Trop. 2-4 on the road. And dealing with the middle of the order now with Maben in scoring position at second. Big strikeout of Cabrera now behind Martinez. Oh, yeah. Headed to short. Miller's throw a little high, and the tag by Morrison taking care of Martinez. So two gone with Maven still at second base.
You know, that was one of those situations where this ball got to him early. Now he's got plenty of time, and that's when he's had his most trouble. You see him kind of feather that ball over there, and Logan Morrison having to come off the bag to make that catch. You know, a lot of times we see Brad Miller rush his throws. They're more accurate than when he has time. There's the tendency.
So two outs, here's Castellanos. Smiley got Castellanos on a ground ball to Evan Longoria in the second inning. Tigers have been pretty consistent this year with mid and scoring position, hitting 271 as a team, 270 with mid and scoring position. They're fourth in the league in runs scored. Thirteenth in team ERA. So that's been an issue. And a nice stop by Conger. Ball, no strikes. Castellanos moving his average back over 300 the last couple of weeks. He's consistently been over 300. Nick. Had a hit and a walk last night. Pops it up foul. That's going to carry into the seats. The count is 1-1. Working his way through the lineup for the second time tonight.
And that really, when we look at the breakout of numbers, this is the time through the lineup that has given Drew Smiley the most trouble. You know, those 19 home runs, 9 of them have come second time through, 5 first time, 5 third time. Average goes up significantly, so does the on-base percentage.
Yeah, there it is right there.
Guys are so good. Ask and you shall receive.
Yep. Those guys in the truck make the show. Liner. That's going to be fair back toward the corner and left. Tigers will take the lead. Maven scores on the Castellanos double, and it's 1-0. 43rd run batted in, and Maven, who's been so tough against the Rays, has scored the only run of this game.
Well, this ball, fastball down. Castellanos just dropped the head. Able to go down and through that baseball, hit a hard liner into the corner. No doubt that was going to be trouble. Maben's going to score, and Castellanos puts himself into scoring position here in the fourth inning.
But it's Justin Upton who struck out in the second inning. Up now with a man at second and two gone. Popped up. That's going to be foul. Out of play it goes for a strike. '28-year-old outfielder. One and one. So the Tigers score first tonight with a run. Smiley trying to limit the damage to just that run as he works against Upton. 2-2. Smiley has faced this club twice, both times at Comerica Park. Comes in 0-1 against him, and now pitching against him here at the Trop. Two and two upstairs. Missed with a fastball.
And Drew Smiley wanted that. You saw the little hop after Justin Upton didn't bite. You know, he's thinking, working him up and down. He got him to chase the changeup down. Watch the fastball up. And right there, you see that little hop and the pound into the glove. He wanted a chase right there, and Upton laid off.
2-2. And he goes foul with that one. Another fastball down in the zone with that one. Pitch count's been pretty good, up to 19 here in this inning. Now the count is full. Upton not fooled by the change of speed. Cavilli's on deck. Ground ball, and that's headed to short. Miller's throw right on the money this time. A run on two hits and one left. Bottom of the fourth coming, 1-0 Detroit. Geico, great moment. The Rays win in walk-off fashion over the Red Sox. Two outs in the 11th, and Rocco Baldelli off second, back, and then he heads to the plate, scores from second when Brandon Lyons' wild pickoff attempt sailed into center field, giving the Rays a victory over Boston. Some great moves there by Rocco Baldelli, now stationary in the he's out of the first base coaching box, but doing that job down there first base for the Rays.
Yeah, those moves now just confined to the dance floor, not the same.
Miller, a 1-0 pitch, and it's hit on the ground at first, and Cabrera takes care of that unassisted for the first down in the bottom of the fourth. Evan Longoria coming off a solid month of June. Fourth in the league in extra base hits now. Fulmer threw him a great pitch, a slider to strike him out in the first. One ball, no strikes. It's foul. It's 1-1. Our Lowe's home field advantage. We track Evan Longoria month by month. It's slugging percentage going up and up and up.
There you go. Well, Matt,
it's pretty good. It's going there. Finding a mathematical pattern. 1-2 the count. He really has had a great first half. And worthy of the All-Star game. Here's a ground ball. Lacey is in short. Takes care of that. A couple of ground balls here in the fourth. Two up and two down. Fulmer can throw some ground balls as well. Just under 50% ground ball rate for him.
You think about the life on his pitches, you know, when he's on top of that fastball and it's down in the zone, it's got some late movement, the slider, the changeup, all pitches that he gets swings and misses on him, and he also gets guys to pound it into the ground. Really what the backbone of his success, keep the ball on the ground, keep the ball in the yard, rack up about a strikeout an inning, but like even the action on that changeup right there.
I mean, every pitch he's thrown has been a good one.
It has.
That changeup, exceptional.
Yep.
And the slider, exceptional. Great velocity on the fastball. Well, let's do it again.
Well, he throws the pitch with conviction. That's the thing. He throws it with conviction, meaning he throws that pitch at it, as his, you watch his body release, you're thinking, that's fastball. He sells it, and all of a sudden it's minus 10, and he's been putting them in good spots too. It's even a bonus.
A ball and two strikes. Three straight changeups here to Logan Morrison.
And if he does decide to come with the fastball, it's going to look like it's 100.
Cut and a miss. Well, he's been something else, this kid. Four straight changeups to Morrison. Six strikeouts in the game. We're through four. It's 1-0 Detroit. fifth. The Tigers lead this game. Follow Rays Baseball Live with the MLB.com at-bat app. Stay up to the moment at any moment with game day, live game video highlights, StatCast news, and a lot more. Download MLB.com at-bat, the number one app for live baseball on your phone and tablet. Mike Avili's leading off the fifth. Pitch is a little wide. It's a 1-0 game. Tigers scored a run in the fourth. Castellanos with a double, sending Cameron Maben across the plate. Ground ball short. Picked up by Brad Miller. High throw, and that's going to be an error. So Miller committing his 11th error of the year. This one on the throw, and Avili's is aboard.
We saw a little foreshadowing the inning before. And here, this ground ball gets to it. He's got plenty of time to set himself, a little crow hop. And then you see that throw drops the elbow a little bit. You drop the elbow, and you're going to miss up and away.
So Drew Smiley now must pitch around that miscue and pick up his shortstop. James McCann. Strike one. As we said before, McCann has hurt Smiley in the past with a long ball. Bill is the runner. Come out in front. 0-2. A little something extra off that changeup. Iglesias on deck. Runner goes, pitches up, and no throw. Conger with a double pump, and then he dropped it. And a stolen base by Avili's.
Well, after the way that Cameron Maben was able to steal his base, you're thinking for the Detroit Tigers, anybody that can run, they're going to challenge. And right here, Conger coming out and just not able to get that ball clean and out of the glove. Knows he's got a rush because it was a pretty good junk by Avili's, and I don't know really if it would have mattered.
There's a swing and a miss. Toss down to first, holding at second of Avili's. So McCann is out on strikes. Yeah, both Maben and Avili's got pretty good jumps. And Conger on his haste could not make a throw.
Swing and a miss off this, off McCann's helmet, right to Conger. Just how you draw it up. Well, you think about this. If that ball somehow goes to the right or the left and over McCann's head, you're still going to get him at first base. But Avili's got a chance to move up to third on that one. So that Rays are fortunate there.
Jose Iglesias. First pitch strike. Takes the fastball. Iglesias retired on a ground ball to Forsyth in the third. Got a 1-0 game, and Smiley trying to keep it that way. Into the dirt, and that's stopped by Conger. 1-1. Two balls and a strike. Off the plate. Well, the man in scoring position, Smiley, slowing his pace a bit. Long look in, and Iglesias stepping back for time.
Well, Iglesias, one of those hitters that'll shorten his swing. He's got that leadoff hitter type of mentality, good two-strike approach. Trying to do the little things, trying to find a hole right here.
And it's down. Two balls, two strikes. And the top of the order, danger there, and Ian Kinsler on deck. Kinsler has good numbers against Smiley and 0 for 2 tonight. Iglesias looks at a strike. So the count is full. To short right center. That ball will fall out of the reach of Arcia. Aviles had to hold for fear the ball might be caught, so he advances only to third. It's first and third with one out, and we're going to go to the top of the order.
Yeah, that ball seemingly hung up there forever. And Aviles, initially, his break is going to be read it. Okay, start to go, and then maybe not. And he actually was heading back towards second when that ball dropped. Right here, he thinks he's got a pretty good read. Nah, maybe I should. That's just a tough read for Aviles. Not much he could do there, and Arcia giving it his best effort, just not able to get there. Tell you what though, at least when that ball bounced, he was able to kind of swat it and keep it close. That ball bounces high and away from him. Maybe Aviles tries to stretch it out, but Arcia coming in, he doesn't have any help behind him. And if that ball misses that wrist, then maybe Aviles tries to get home, but he swatted it, kept it close. That was a nice job by Arcia.
So here's Kinsler, key spot in the game now, and he takes the pitch a little low. One ball, no strikes. Kinsler, two strikeouts tonight. Came into the game 5 out of 13 with a home run off Smiley in his career. Tigers, after scoring a run in the fourth, have a one-out threat in the fifth. Foul right back over the screen. Smiley starts his third time through the order. Aviles reached on the error. McCann struck out. A steal of second by Aviles. A move to third. On the base hit by Iglesias. Fly ball into right. Arcia lining up to make the catch. Tag at third. Aviles will hang on. And down to second goes Iglesias. Aviles decides not to try to score. And Arcia made a good throw to the plate.
One of the better decisions Mike Aviles will ever make. I mean, Oswaldo Arcia, he would have gotten him into a rundown. There would not have even been a play. This was a absolute bullet right on the money.
So two outs, now two men in scoring position.
See, it started with the swat and then the throw.
One step at a time.
That's it. One out away.
Here's Cameron Maben. Well, he's been a nemesis to the Rays. Fouls the pitch back. He singled to open the fourth and has scored the only run of the game. Three hits last night, including the big double in the ninth inning. Rabin now 4 of 5 against Smiley. So Smiley hoping that tide is about to turn. Fly ball, short right near the line. Arcia on the run, foul ball, and he can't make the catch. He went sliding into foul territory. And so that's a strike. Well, he made an effort.
2 out of 3 ain't bad, Dwayne.
Here you go. Well, you'd like to see that one executed there.
And he's following it the whole way, and as he goes down.
Two steps forward and one step back.
It's about the process.
Pitch low to Maben and blocked by Conger. 1 and 2. One, two, into the dirt.
Yikes.
Yes, 2 balls, 2 strikes now.
Yeah, that's a great block by Conger because, boy, this pitch out of the hand, you needed a cutoff man. It was so short. Breaking ball, spiked, and Conger, look at him stay right over top of it. Take that ball high up off the chest, but keep it in front. That saves a run.
2-2. Ground ball headed up the middle and a base hit in the center. Avili scores. Iglesias crosses the plate. Maben does it again. Makes it a 3-0 game with a single in the center.
Did you see him shorten his swing and get on top of this pitch? Look at Conger wants it up. That ball was up. That pitch was executed by Drew Smiley. And look at how he gets on top of it. I'm going to tell you something. This kid has been ridiculously impressive in this series, the way that he's changing his swing to fit the situation and the pitch that he's anticipating.
Saw it happen last night.
I mean, the way that he changed that to get underneath that changeup by Erasmo Ramirez and get it airborne, impressive enough, and then shorten up on the swing and get on top of the elevated fastball, thinking, okay, he just went off speed below the zone. I know the pattern. I'm going to be ready for the heater up. And he was short, quick to it, and found a hole. I'll tell you, that's impressive.
Now Miguel Cabrera gets to the plate. A looper in the center, and out there is Forsythe from second base to grab it and retire the side. 2-run score. We go to the bottom of the fifth, 3-0. the fifth inning. And it's a 3-0 ball game. Rays Live, the pregame show tomorrow begins at 3:30. Blake Snell on the mound, and we'll hear from him in the third game of this four-game series. Brandon Guyer leading off here. Strike the count on him. Strike count, Guyer, Dickerson, and Franklin. It's a foul ball straight back into the upper deck. A swing and a miss. Guyer's out on strikes.
There's that changeup again. You know, a lot of times you'll see a right-handed or left-handed pitcher will be reluctant to throw the changeup. In this case, he's got that split change like we see a lot of the Rays pitchers feature, but they'll be reluctant to throw that pitch to the same side hitter. You know, right on right, you kind of stay away from the changeup. You go fastball, slider, and throw it a lot more to left-handed hitters. But we've seen Fulmer not afraid to throw it right-handed, left-handed, has enough confidence in that pitch. Anybody will see it.
Well, he was a little reluctant. You know, he's got that fastball and a great slider. And McCann, there's a little tap. McCann grabs it barehanded, makes the throw to first, close. And Dickerson is out. Good play by McCann, the catcher, to get Dickerson second out. McCann really has encouraged Fulmer to throw that changeup more, and he has three strikeouts on that pitch tonight. As you mentioned, the last one to the right-handed hitter Guyer, and that changeup is a great pitch.
Well,
so you can see why they'd want him to throw it.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. That pitch, you know, good pitch is a good pitch. Right-handed, left-handed, you know, it doesn't matter. And so in recognizing that and getting a guy that sits behind the plate and goes, listen, I know what that pitch does. And so give that to me. Righties, lefties, it doesn't matter. There's enough action and deception that it's gonna work against either one. And you know, anytime you can get that kind of input from your teammates, guys that have been around, you being the rookie, you just soak that right in.
Well, there's nothing better, and I think you're the guy to speak to this. You're a young pitcher. You have a veteran catcher. You have a catcher you have confidence in. There's no better relationship that a young pitcher can have than a catcher who he has a great deal of confidence in.
Yeah. Yeah, no, there have been a few special moments I've had throughout my career with, you know, a catcher. I think about the time that I was with Tim Laker. And Tim Laker, yep, at that point was, you know, the backup catcher with the Indians, Josh Bard, mm-hmm, sharing time. And we got on a roll together, and it was almost like it was like ESP. I mean, you didn't even need to speak. You just threw, and he caught.
Franklin out on a fastball, three up, three down, 3-0 Detroit. Miller tonight, and he has been in top form through five innings, B.A., just 59 pitches through five.
Corey Dickerson got on top of a heater and went back up the middle. That's the Rays' only hit. No walks, big strikeout numbers. Nick Castellanos got a pitch down and out over the plate. He was able to get down into the corner to give the Tigers an early lead. And Cameron Maben, what can you say about him and what he's done to the Rays? Gets on top of that fastball, uses the middle of the field. He was looking for that pitch, or at least ready for that pitch. And then Drew Smyly, a little in-between inning meltdown as he trails and the Rays trail 3-0.
Yeah, you know, you look at this Tiger team and you think, well, you don't want Cabrera to hurt you, Victor Martinez, Ian Kinsler. Well, it's Cameron Maben who has just been a major problem for the Rays in the season series so far. Now Victor Martinez takes the pitch outside 1-0.
He's got 22 runs driven in.
Yep.
10 of them have come against the Rays in what's not even a five completed games yet. And yep, he's 12 out of 18. That's 667 with 10 of his 22 runs batted in coming against the Rays.
And I think the point you made about the hit he had last night and the hit he had last inning, right on. I mean, you got to give him a lot of credit as a hitter to do what he's done with those pitches.
I'm telling you, that as good of situational hitting as I have seen this year, period. You know, that you go back and we'll beat it to death, but Rays have the infield in. Erasmo Ramirez on the mound, going to a changeup to try to get a ground ball, something down. And Maben changes his whole swing and swing path to get underneath that pitch and get it elevated into the outfield. Little did he know that was going to turn into a bases clearing double. And then that last at bat against Smyly, off speed down below the zone. You've got to be ready for that elevated heater, which Drew Smyly has beaten so many of these hitters on. And he gets on top of a pitch up around his shoulders and takes it right back up the middle. Shortens the swing, just takes the barrel to the baseball. Short, quick, finds a hole, two runs driven in. I mean, it's as good as you're going to see.
Well, a full count to Victor Martinez here, leading off the sixth. And he strikes him out. Came back with the fastball. So that's seven strikeouts, now eight strikeouts, I guess, for Smyly tonight.
Now this is what we were talking about last night. Infield in, look at how he just changed. Like, just stay back and look, trying to get underneath that pitch that's down in the zone and just elevate and lift it. You saw him just cut the swing off, just getting it in the air, maybe a sack fly to give the team the lead. It ends up getting over Dickerson's head, and that led to three runs and led to the 10-7 victory. You take that swing and then the swing last inning against Drew Smyly, how different they were, and both of them combined to drive in five runs.
Yeah, he's been the problem for the Rays.
I mean, really,
in this series and going back into Detroit.
And his performance now has absolutely eclipsed that necklace for impressive.
In fact, he might have earned that necklace with the performances we've seen.
Without a doubt. The necklace had an early lead coming into play today, and he has gone above and beyond that rope.
1-1 the count to Castellanos. Two. Three runs, four hits for Detroit, no runs, and one hit for the Rays. Bounding in, 2-2. Smyly into the sixth inning. One out, base is empty. coming back from the five inning outing against Baltimore on the road when he gave up 8 runs, 10 hits. Touch for 3 home runs in that one. He's upstairs now. The count is full. And he's on the verge of pitch number 100. Here it is, and it's upstairs. Castellanos on for the second straight time. One on, one out. Well, stay cool this summer with the Rays floppy hat presented by the Florida Department of Transportation and is modeled by Todd Callis. Get yours when the Rays take on the Detroit Tigers Saturday, July 2nd, while supplies last. Call 888-FAN-RAYS or visit RaysBaseball.com for more information. Rays up.
Yeah, apparently our crew down in the truck has no interest in me getting any sleep this homestand.
Ground ball, and it's just out of the reach of Miller off the bat of Upton. A turn. Castellanos hangs on at second, and it's first and second. Ball sneaking through. Right. Two men on.
Yep. That ground ball. Ugh. Make the diving attempt. Just a foot or so off the edge of that glove. And now the Tigers two on, one out.
Danny Farquhar up in the bullpen for the Rays. Velez on the ground is short. Miller, Forsythe one, Morrison two, 6-4, three and out. We go to the bottom of the sixth, 3-0 Detroit. On Fox Sports Sun, brought to you by Dodge. Visit your local Dodge dealer today. By Kubota. For more information, go to FloridaKubotaDealers.com. By St. Luke's Cataract and Laser Institute. World-class care right in Tampa Bay. And by your local Toyota dealers. Let's go places. Well, we go to the Rays half of the sixth. Oswaldo Arcia leads off, takes the change up too low. Side 2-0. Well, the Rays got a 2-out single from Dickerson in the second inning, and that's been it so far off the 23-year-old right-hander Michael Fulmer. 3-0 the count on Arcia. The
that would be nice to be able to get that leadoff runner aboard, a three-run deficit starting to get a little bit late. And Fulmer, you know, that pitch count in pretty good working order as of now.
That was a strike. He had 59 pitches through five with eight strikeouts. Four pitches into the sixth, 3-1 the count. Cutting a miss at the fastball, back full.
Well, you know, that's when you have a guy, it's a stuff guy, when they do fall behind, they can still be aggressive like that. A 3-1 heater, that's what RC is looking for, and he's still able to power it by him because of that velocity in late life.
And ball four, he walks the leadoff man. So the Rays get their first base runner since the two-out single in the second by Dickerson.
And now you get Fulmer right into the stretch.
He had retired 10 straight. Yeah, he's made only five pitches out of the stretch tonight. We're in the sixth inning. And here is Hank Conger. Upstairs. No ball, no strikes. Conger popped out to the first baseman Cabrera on a high popper in the third. It's fouled back and into the upper deck. 1-1 the count. Two and one. Well, not much brewing for the Rays so far, but they have the leadoff man on in the bottom of the sixth, the top of the order's on deck in Logan Forsythe. Conger with a 2-1 count. Now snap throw to first and back in Arcia. Count goes to 2-2 on Conger. McCann taking a shot, throwing behind the hitter down to first. And Arcia got back before the tag. Swing and a miss. Conger out on strikes. Go online now to bid on hitting lessons with Logan Forsythe. This one-of-a-kind experience includes a one-hour session of hitting lessons, pregame field passes, personalized baseball bats, and a lot more. Proceeds to benefit the Rays Baseball Foundation and the Tampa General Hospital Foundation. To bid, visit RaysBaseball.com/auction.
That's an item right there. That's an item because this guy at the plate right now knows how to hit.
Yep.
Knows about approach, knows about, you know, going to the plate with a plan. He's got that up the middle, the other way approach. If a pitcher wants to pitch him in, he's quick enough to react to it. He's able to cover everything.
Fundamentally sound and can transmit that. So he'd be a great guy to talk hitting with.
I'm going to bid on that and then try to make a comeback as an outfielder.
There you go. Why not? With that great speed, you'd cover all kinds of ground out there.
What would be left in the arm? I could make probably one good throw every three or four innings. And then when the feeling came back, I could do it again.
Yep.
Use a little hose, let the feeling come back.
Over to first, stepping back onto the bag, Arcia. One on with one out. Rays have not had a man as far as second base against Fulmer tonight. Only two runners.
Thank you.
Fouled out of play. Farquhar up again in the bullpen. Smiley a little over 100 pitches through six. Tapper third base. Castellanos scoops, throws to first. Forsyth is out. Arcia moves into second. Now the Rays do get a man as far as second. It comes here in the sixth with two away.
And you know what's interesting is in both cases, the way that Michael Fulmer played it out, two strikes, he went slide step changeup. So you speed your motion up. You go with a slide step. So all of a sudden, now you're coming at the hitter a little bit quicker than you normally do, and the pitch is slower. He got the strikeout on Conger and the little ground ball here by Logan Forsythe. You know, sometimes you'll use that slide step to control the running game. Other times you'll use the slide step to try to fool with the timing of a hitter. And a slide step changeup, one of the best pitches out there.
I think five of his last six strikeouts have come on the changeup. Here's Brad Miller. Ground ball headed toward the middle, backhanded by Kinsler, and the throw to first. The flip throw is right there. Nice play by Kinsler. And the Rays are out. They leave a man at second in the sixth. It's 3-0 at the end of six, Detroit.
That looked way too.
Sports Zone brought to you by Dodge. Visit your local Dodge dealer today. By Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And by your Southern Chevy dealers. Drew Smiley on to the seventh. 102 pitches for Smiley so far in this game. He'll face James McCann, the catcher. Then Iglesias and Kinsler. The first pitch just missed. An off-speed pitch, 1-0. He has struck out McCann twice tonight. Ball's behind him, 2-0. Eight strikeouts for Smiley, nine for Fulmer. That's a strike. 2-1. Drew's strikeout high this year, 12. That came three starts ago against Seattle. Fly ball short center, and that's going to drop. Guyer and Arcia converge. Arcia makes the pickup. McCann has a base hit to open the seventh. Let's check in right now with Todd Callis.
Hey, Dwayne, some good news from just south of the Sunshine Skyway. That's where Steven Souza Jr. today participated in a game with the Charlotte Stone Crabs down in Bradenton. He's on the DL with that left hip strain. Tonight, even though he went 0 for 3, he was on base three times. A walk, and he reached on a couple of errors, stole a base, scored a run, also got thrown out trying to score another run. And the fact that he's going to be reevaluated tomorrow is a good sign. A lot of times you'll see the Rays put a plan together with a guy DHing one night after he plays the outfield. Souza played the outfield tonight. Will be reevaluated. We could see him sooner than later, guys.
Well, that would be good news. The Rays trying to get that disabled list depleted because the everyday roster has been depleted with injuries. And the quicker they can get those guys back, the better.
Have you noticed that every time we've gone to Todd, his hair has been different?
Iglesias puts down a bunt, scooped by Longoria. And they throw out Iglesias with McCann bunted up to second base. 5-3 on that play. Iglesias moves the runner over. That's part of Todd's versatility. Versatile in more ways than one.
Yeah, see now, see the part is down the middle now. Mm-hmm. The last time it was pulled over to the side, there's a total change there.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's a man of many talents, and the variety is endless.
By the way, what was he going with right there? Come on, Ahab.
Yeah, he just,
there you go.
Yeah, he's trying to check us out from his spot into our booth.
I don't have a part in my hair, Todd.
Ian Kinsler sends a fly ball to center. Guyer back to make the catch, trying to get into position to throw. McCann's going to tag in advance, however. Well, a good effort by Guyer to get over there to catch it and to find himself in a position to make a play. But a move up to third, nevertheless, by McCann.
That fly ball just a little bit too deep. And that's why McCann able to scamper over to third base now with two outs. Important here with the off-speed stuff and the way that they're going to attack Maven. You know, Hank Conger going to have to be ready to block some pitches, perhaps. Find a way to get this guy out.
Well, Maben 2-for-3. Trouble again tonight from Cameron Maben for the Rays. Tapper foul. Strike the count. He's driven in two runs. Three runs given up by Smiley. Only one earned. Both the runs and the fifth were unearned as a result of the error on Miller. Now strike two. Pitches. 112, the single game season high for Smiley this year. Low, covered up by Conger. 1-2. Conger went 7 innings, 2 starts ago against Cleveland, 7 against the Yankees earlier this year, an 8 inning stint against Boston, and 7 against Cleveland the first time around when the Indians played here at the Trop in April. 1-2 the count. Miguel Cabrera on deck. And now ball three. Another pitch down. Three, two to Maben, and he walks him. Maben goes to first. McCann's aboard at third. 115 pitches for Smiley. His career high is 116. That came last, well, a couple years ago in August of 14 against the Texas Rangers. Stays on to face Miguel Cabrera. That's low. Cabrera walked in the first. Since then, he has struck out and popped out to second. Pops it up foul. That will carry into the stands. The count is 1-1. One pitch, cut the miss. Now it's 1-2.
It's that cutter working down and in. Seen Smiley throw a number of those this inning, a couple of to Maben that were out of the zone.
Move to first, Maben back in. Can opened with a single. He's at third. Maben walked with two outs. First and third. The 1-2 to Cabrera. Fastball in on him and he fouls it. The next pinch will be number 120. For a career high in pitch count for Smiley tonight against his former club, the Detroit Tigers. This one is low, 2-2, curveball. Scored in the fourth, one run, two more unearned in the fifth. Two to Cabrera, and it bounces away from Conger. McCann will score, and up to second base goes Maben, and the Tigers get another run.
That was the fear. That was the fear. You know, with Cabrera, you're going to be, there's a changeup. It's down in the zone, and Hank Conger tries to backhand that ball, doesn't roll the glove over and block it traditional. And that's a tough backhand to the glove side, and that's why that ball ends up getting redirected over towards the Tiger dugout and gives them another run.
Run on the wild pitch. On the changeup, it's 4-0. And Cabrera takes that one for a ball, and he's going to head to first. Pitching change coming. Kevin Cash out to make the change. pitches for Drew Smyly tonight. 6 2/3. 6 hits, 4 runs. A couple of unearned runs in the fifth inning. He strikes out 8, walks 4. This game was scoreless until the fourth. Cameron Maben came up with a base hit in the fifth to drive in 2. Wild pitch scored a run here in the seventh inning. So it's a 4-run deficit as Smyly leaves in favor of Danny Farquhar. Right-hander facing Victor Martinez with 2 Detroit runners aboard at first and second. Breaking ball to start Martinez, a swing and a miss. Farquhar got the final 2 outs in the ninth inning last night. One and one. Balls and a strike. Fastball is high out of the zone.
The one guy you do not want to get into bad counts against is Victor Martinez. Already talked about his exploits as a hitter. Can't fall any further behind than 4 where you already are. Now in a 3-1 count, you got to be careful here.
McCann started this with a leadoff single. He has scored the additional run. Castellanos is on deck. Three and two. Cut at the fastball.
Oh, yeah. Challenge, challenge. Won that one. We'll win one more.
Runners on the move with a full count, 2 gone. Foul ball. Four 6-0 for Detroit. The Rays, no runs, just 1 hit. Only a couple of base runners to this point. Two again, and a high shot deep into right field, way up, and that one is out of here. That's a home run off the ring. A 3-run shot to make it a 4-run inning. 3-2 pitch, and Martinez did not miss that one. His 15th home run of the year, and suddenly it's a 7-0 ball game.
This ball stays down. It's working its way in right into the swing path of Victor Martinez, and this ball had height, distance, everything. Got lost up there in that C ring, way up there, before then falling harmlessly down into the outfield, bounced into the stands. But that ball was a no doubter.
Seven runs, 7 hits for Detroit. The breaking ball into Castellanos for a strike. the ninth fair ball this year to hit the C ring. And that completes the book on Smiley. Two of those runs charged to him. So on the night, six runs charged to Smiley. Here's the home run. The swing by Martinez off the C ring. Now 2-2 to Nick Castellanos. Six runs, four earned off Smiley. Back into the screen. It's off its foot. Try to walk that one off. Well, the Tigers, who opened this inning with a three-run lead on a run in the fourth, doubled home by Castellanos, and then two unearned runs in the fifth, have broken it open with a four-run top of the seventh inning, and Smiley wandering the dugout.
Well, just an awful feeling. You know, he's not been in the win column since May the 16th. It's been a tough run for Drew. It's been a tough run for the team. And You know you're going to have your hands full with Michael Fulmer the way that he's been throwing the baseball, and Drew Smiley hung in there for a while, and then all of a sudden the Detroit Tigers, benefit of an error, Cameron Maben, a nice job of situational hitting, and then have blown it open at this point.
Well, the full count, the breaking ball stayed in to Castellanos. And he hits a little popper that's going to be out of the reach of Forsyth into shallow center, and he's on for the third time. A base hit into center.
Not the most picturesque of swings, but he got the ball safely into center field.
Just out of the reach of Forsyth. And now Justin Upton. Tigers send their eighth hitter to the plate in the seventh inning. First pitch is a strike. By him, nothing in two. And lifts a popper first base side. Morrison toward the stands. He is out of room. And we'll see another 0-2 pitch. Ten runs for Detroit last night in that 10-7 final, and seven runs tonight. Strike count. Now 1-2. Oh. 2-2. And a struggle for Farquhar here.
Now that's been the story of the Rays bullpen. It's been a struggle across the board for just about anybody who's coming in.
And he misses again.
And there are no backups. There are no reserves here for Danny Farquhar. He's going to have to figure it out himself because that bullpen is awfully quiet. Jim Hickey and manager Kevin Cash trying to figure it out.
It's a popper. It's going to wind up out of play as well. He's going to have to make another full count pitch. He's gone 3-2 to all three hitters. Two. Popper short center. Forsyth out there and makes a nice over the shoulder catch to finally retire the Tigers in the seventh. Seventh inning stretch time, 7-0. Penning coming, the Rays find themselves down by 7. A four-run top half of this inning by Detroit. Three of those coming on the home run by Victor Martinez. Evan Longoria to lead off the bottom of the 7th. And he takes the first pitch, a fastball in at 96, a little bit high. So here we are opening the 7th, and Fulmer comes right out at 96. High fly ball, not overly deep, right center. Maben is there. One away. Rays have a hit. That came in the 2nd inning. They're going to walk in the 6th, and that's it off Fulmer tonight.
Yeah, it's been the Michael Fulmer show, and then the Detroit offense here showed up a little bit late, but they put 7 runs on the board, and you know what you were hoping for. I mean, the way that Fulmer was throwing the baseball was, well, he had to sit for a long time that last half inning. Maybe he comes out a little off, but not so much. Still, the velocity's still there. Retired Evan Longoria on 2 pitches and out in front here on Logan Morrison.
Yeah, first pitch 96 to Morrison. He came out firing.
You know, it's pretty, you know, you look back at that little run that Fulmer has had since that start against the Rays. He had a four-start stretch of at least six innings pitched, three hits or fewer given up, and zero runs.
Yep.
Four straight. I mean, it's, you know, just that's domination at the major league level.
Yeah, and on the front side of that, he gave up the one run to the Rays, and then since then, one run to Kansas City and one to Seattle.
Yeah.
So he's been tough against everybody.
Like I said early in the game when we were opening this thing up, was, you know, the one thought that you had coming in was he's never faced the same team twice. You know, and that's a big difference. So a team's faced you, they know what you feature. They remember, you know, the arm slot, the action on the pitches, and now they can game plan for you accordingly. And so this was the first time that Fulmer was going to be facing a team that he's already faced, and he's actually better this time around against the Rays than he was the first time.
Yeah, he's on a run now, retiring 14 of the last 15 he's faced. It's a foul ball. He's done it with all of his pitches, that fastball and the slider. He's broken out the changeup and has used that to his advantage.
You know, and as good as a slider as he has, I think that's been his third pitch here tonight. I mean, it's been good, but I would put that third in pecking order with the fastball and the changeup.
Yep, five of his strikeouts on the changeup. Nine strikeouts so far. There's a shot into center. It's in there, one hop to Maven and a base hit. Turn at first by Morrison. So the Rays have a base runner.
Well, this is Michael Fulmer and what he's done here tonight. There's the slider early against Forsythe and Longoria. And then the fastball, the little bit of elevation, then the changeup would take over. And that pitch has been absolutely phenomenal. He's been able to use it to both sides of the plate. Get a little dipping action at the end. And starting to rack up some strikeouts with it.
One on, one out. Here's Guyer. Brandon struck out on the fastball his first time on the changeup in the fifth. And the right-hander Fulmer starts him with the changeup here in the seventh. Pop up, right side, Kinsler angling out. Now the right fielder Aviles is there to make the catch in behind Kinsler. Two gone. David Ortiz, Bryce Harper, Mike Trout, and all of baseball's superstars come together for the primetime event that will light up the summer. The MLB All-Star Game from San Diego, July 12th. Only on Fox. Corey Dickerson, one for two tonight. A strike call. So Dickerson has one of the two hits collected off Fulmer tonight. You know, he came into this game with an earned run average of 240, and you're starting to think, how could it be that high the way he's pitched tonight?
When the Rays saw him the first time, he had a 652, 6.52. You're like, yep. Oh, the young rookie, 6.52 ERA, and since then he has not looked back. He has been fantastic from that start right on through here, two outs in the seventh.
High foul ball down the left side. Upton's not going to be able to get there. So the count remains nothing and two Gave up a couple of runs in five innings against Minnesota. Then he gave up five and five to the Indians. In Washington, the Nationals, three runs, five innings. And then in Baltimore, all of those on the road, five runs in four and a third. Then that game against the Rays, one run in seven. Then the stretch of four, giving up nothing that you mentioned. A run against Kansas City, a run against Seattle, and nothing tonight to the Rays.
And how about this? So this is his 12th start of the season, the ninth on the road. He's only pitched up at Comerica Park three times.
Yeah, that came against the Rays and the Blue Jays and the Mariners. This will be his 90th pitch of the night. And it's fouled back.
Tried that slide step changeup once again. It's been a pitch that he's brought out into some spots here, a little that he's been out of the stretch. That pitch count in nice working order still.
His high pitch count was 106. That was the game against the Rays when he gave up a run, four hits in seven innings, struck out 11. So he has 20 strikeouts against the Rays in just under 14 innings. One ball, two strikes. Seven runs, eight hits for the Tigers. No runs, two hits for the Rays. Nick Franklin would be next if Dickerson could work his way aboard. Right now, down on the count. And he's out on strikes. Fulmer hits double figures with 10 strikeouts. No runs, a hit, the man left. That's 21 strikeouts in 14 innings for Fulmer against the Rays. Sports Sun brought to you by Dodge. Visit Dodge.com today. By Nissan. Choose Nissan today for great offers on our most exciting lineup ever. And by your Gulf Coast Honda dealers. Michael Fulmer, the 23-year-old right-hander, has been very tough tonight. A 10 strikeout performance through seven. We go to the eighth. Dana Evelyn is on the hill for the Rays, their third pitcher. Mike Aviles leads it off for Detroit. First pitch is a strike from the veteran left-hander. McCann next, and then Iglesias. Line drive, and it's grabbed by Morrison. Nice catch by Logan Morrison down at first. That's out number one in the eighth.
Boy, use all of that frame and that length to make that play. Save extra bases, save more heartache.
Now the catcher, James McCann. Well, McCann, who had hit a couple of home runs over the last couple outings off Smiley, opened the seventh with a base hit, and that eventually led to four runs. McCann takes a strike. Green up in the bullpen for Detroit. Homer's gone seven tonight. A ball and a strike. Two and one. Tomorrow it'll be Blake Snell and Justin Verlander. The young lefty against the veteran Verlander. He'll be with you at 3:30. First pitch at 4:10 tomorrow. Base hit, shot into center. McCann's on again. Makes a wide turn, but Guyer gets the ball back toward the infield. McCann is 2-for-4 tonight.
Yeah, what a contrast this is going to be. You know, the flame-throwing young lefty against the flame-throwing veteran right-hander. And Blake Snell, the great future he has ahead of him. See the four starts, the 1-2 record. Got that first major league win his last time out. ERA just over 3.5. That's going to be a fun matchup to be a part of.
And then Sunday in the wrap-up game of this series, but not the homestand, Chris Archer against Mike Pelfrey, a couple of right-handers. 1-0 the count to Iglesias.
Yeah, I mean, longest homestand of the year. I almost, it crossed my mind to maybe unpack on this trip and treat it as if I was going to be home for a while, and I thought better of it at the end of the day. But the fact that I considered it, I thought was big.
Yeah, that was big. Very difficult to unpack completely during the season.
You can't.
No. You leave the suitcase out.
Right. Yep. There's a designated area where the suitcase stays open. You do the laundry, and a lot of it gets replaced. You don't go putting it into drawers. It just adds to the degree of difficulty and then the hassle.
Yeah, if you've got some folded shirts already folded, you leave them in there.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I agree, but I thought, you know, 11 days?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah,
the thought.
Had
the
a
thought
shot.
Was there. I don't even know why I bought furniture. Since empty.
2-2 the count on Iglesias with a runner at first and one out. And then it's just a short little trip up to Boston, and we're back into the All-Star break that quickly.
Yeah.
Ground ball outside of third, foul. So one on, one out. We should get Todd Callis involved in this.
All right.
What do you do with your suitcase and the road and all that, Todd?
Yeah, Dwayne, within every city we go to, within 2 hours of the luggage arriving, everything is in the drawers and hung up. The suitcase, the clothes bag, empty. Every city. That's how I roll.
What? So that's where you've been. That's a lot. That's time consuming to do all that.
Right. So then, you know what? You start to piece it together. And the hour at which he shows up and meets up with us, and the fact that he has wet hair means that he was unpacking and showering
Yes.
before he ends up showing up. And here we had no idea all the theories have just been shot down.
Everything unfolded, then refolded, ironed. You know, the whole thing. That's takes a lot of time.
I've got three.
Here's Longoria. Nice throw down to second out there. Not in time at first.
I've got three letters for you, Dwayne. O, C, and a D. On Todd Callis with the unpacking. You know, when we get into some of these cities, it feels like we're there for 15, 20 minutes tops.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine unpacking your suitcase and putting everything away in the drawers and hanging the hanging the stuff up? I get. You got to do that.
Yeah, a couple. Yeah.
Because you got to iron.
Yeah.
You don't want to come to the ballpark looking like you picked your colored shirt out of your wallet.
And look how content he is right there.
So happy.
It's like a king on his throne.
He loves to bring the not so great news.
Yeah. Yeah. Look at that. So, that's great to hear. So we've uncovered something tonight. The mystery of how Todd spends so much time away from us on the road.
That's right.
Ground ball. Nice. Oh, diving stop. Longoria down to second. Nice play right there to end the top of the eighth. Iglesias forced at second base on the shot by Kinsler. No runs, a hit, and the man left. We go to the bottom of the eighth. It's a 7-0 ball game, Detroit. The eighth, and Michael Fulmer's evening is complete, and boy, what a night he had.
Well, I mean, picking up where he left off against the Rays the last time, and really everybody that he's faced since then, and the line speaks for itself. But I will tell you this, for the, you know, the fact that he's got a 95, 96 mile an hour fastball and a good slider, the changeup tonight was deluxe, and that helped him get that 7 shutout innings with 10 punch outs.
Shane Green, the new pitcher, 27-year-old right-hander. And it's a 1-0 count to Nick Franklin, starting the bottom of the eighth. Foul back, 1-1. Denny Romero loosening in the bullpen for the Rays. Franklin, then Arcia and Conger do up. Little tap right side. Green heads to first. Race for the bag. Close down there. And that's the first out. So Franklin out. Cabrera to Green. Now is Waldo Arcia coming up. Castellanos heads from third into short right. Marcia tonight walked in the sixth. He's 0 for 1. A ball, no strikes. Pop left side, and it hits the B ring and falls fair, but it hit foul. It hit the B ring in foul territory, so that's a dead ball.
Really good attempt, though, by Iglesias. And he's going over, heading that way, because he's the only one on this side of the infield. And that ball ricocheted off that ring pretty far out. See him circling back.
Yeah, that's a great effort. You know, made one of the greatest catches off the rings here. It's a ground ball right side, and Castellanos from short right is there to throw him out. The Tigers' current first base coach, Omar Vizquel, made a great catch when he was playing for the Indians at shortstop here when a ball hit off the rings in fair territory and came down and he caught it.
I'm shocked.
There he is.
I'm shocked that he made a tremendous defensive play.
That's just par for the course.
Jeez.
Yep.
One of the best really to ever play the game. Mm-hmm. His hands out at shortstop. Yeah, he said when he was growing up that until he was, 11, 12, 13 years old, he was playing without a glove.
That's right.
So yep. He said once he got to the United States playing, Major League Baseball on these manicured fields with a glove, he said it felt like it was cheating. It just was too easy.
Yeah, yep.
And that's why you saw him be so proficient at the bare hand play, like it was nothing.
He'd done it all his life. Conger pops it up, foul back a third. That's out of play, 0-2. Two outs, bases empty. And a two-strike count on Conger. Yeah, he's talking about that right now. He says, I remember I made that play. And he did. It hit the ring, and he went out from shortstop into shallow left and made the great catch out there. So he knows how to even play the rings here and be proficient at that. One and two now. This pitch is down. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Cut the miss. Conger out on strikes. 1-2-3. Go the Rays. We are through 8. 7-0 Detroit. The Rays call upon Eddie Romero, their fourth pitcher tonight. Coming up on Rays Live, the postgame presented by Checkers. Michael Fulmer continues to dominate. He has pitched so well lately in two of those outings against the Rays. We'll hear from Kevin Cash in his postgame press conference and further interviews from the clubhouse. Well, Romero will face Cameron Maben. The pitch is low. Maben tonight has been on three times, and that's nothing new. Tough against the Rays. Fouls back the fastball. 1-1.
Well, and if you would have compiled a list of Detroit Tiger hitters that you were afraid would hurt the Rays when this season started, or even this series, I don't think Cameron Maben would have been in your top five.
No.
I mean, you start with Cabrera.
Yeah.
You've worked Victor Martinez, Ian Kinsler, J.D. Martinez before he went on a disabled list.
Mm-hmm. Now it's 3-1 to Maben. Well, he's been central in this season series, the matchups with the Rays. Cabrera's on deck. 3-1, and Maben lines it off the glove of Miller and into left. He's aboard again. On base for the fourth time tonight. After the big night he had last night, he had three hits, including the three-run double in the ninth, and has a hit here to open the ninth tonight.
Boy, that was a rocket. I mean, that ball was shot out of a cannon. Brad Miller just throwing that glove up, get it somewhere near that baseball. Now took it off his hand.
Now Cabrera aboard. Maben makes a turn and holds. Cabrera picking up his first hit of the night. Two men on, nobody out. Now Victor Martinez, the DH. Martinez homered in the seventh. Down to third. That's a foul ball. That would have been interesting had it been fair. Longoria had a shot at a triple play right there.
You know, Victor Martinez, with the legs and the lead, he's got to be taking it easy going down to first base. There's no question about that.
Just about a little more than a foot away from a triple play.
Yeah, step, Miguel Cabrera, Victor Martinez. I think you're right, Dwayne. I don't think it's that close.
Now the shot off the bat of Martinez, and that one is out of here. An 0-1 pitch, and three hitters into the ninth. Another home run for Victor Martinez, his second three-run home run in as many at-bats.
Well, that was Victor Martinez's version of a triple play. For the second time from both sides of the plate.
So suddenly a six RBI night. And it's 10-0 Detroit. Nobody out here in the ninth, and Romero touched up for three runs on one swing of the bat from Victor Martinez. There's a ball to Castellanos.
Yeah.
out of play. It's 1-1. Shot into right field off the bat of Castellanos, and it's caught on the track by Arcia for the out. Castellanos hit that one a long way to the opposite field.
Unfortunately, Arcia was playing deep. Because you're right, that ball was well struck. It had been a frustrating couple of nights here at Tropicana Field.
Well, here's Upton. He had a base hit in the sixth. Oh, 2. High popper right side. That's foul, chased by Morrison. He's going to have a play, and he can't hold it. Actually wound up overrunning that one just a little bit. Tried to come back on it and could not hold it.
That ball had so much spin on it. You know, and he goes over there trying to find that low wall. And you're right, Dwayne, that ball spinning back towards the field with the action that was on it, how high it was hit.
He'll be charged with an error.
That ball actually hit right into the pocket of the glove and rolled out the top. It's been that kind of night.
1-2. Two and two. Six runs charged to Smiley, four earned. One to Farquhar. Now three to Romero. 10 runs, 12 hits for the Tigers. And there's strike three called on Upton. He turns and slowly walks away. Two gone. Now Mike Aviles. Pitch is a strike. One and one. Two balls and a strike. With a strike on the outside part of the plate. 2-2. Fouls it out of play. Smiley, Farquhar, Evelyn, and Romero. And the pitch misses. That's ball three. Navili's trying to coax a walk on the third ball of the count. 3-2 now.
You know, we did that math problem on Evan Longoria's home runs. Mm-hmm. We could do a little 2 + 1 does not equal 4.
That's right. And there's a line drive, and he gets a base hit over Miller's head. He'd rather have a hit than a walk anyway.
Yeah, he would say, you know what, you're right, smart guy, but it does equal single to left field. Another hit.
So that's 13 hits now for Detroit. So Avila's is aboard, and the Kevin Cash comes out, and that's going to be it for Romero. He's going to leave the game, and Taylor Motter is going to come in. Motter will come in out of pitch here in the ninth inning. So two-thirds of an inning, 4 hits off Romero, 3 runs, responsible for a man on.
Your attention, please.
Gave up a home run. So Taylor Motter will come on to pitch.
The shot to clear, coming on to get that final out. Anxious to see this, Dwayne. You know, he's mixed some over-the-top little, you know, three-quarter arm slots, mm-hmm. sidearm. Going to give you a different look, maybe. We'll see.
Look at that. So some different looks. So you'd assume he may have been throwing underneath.
Yeah, he had.
Get loose.
Yeah. You would assume, absolutely. Be in the cage.
Well, it's a 6th time in Rays history that a position player has taken the mound. Well, it was a tough night last night, and it's turning out to be a long evening for Kevin Cash and the Rays again tonight. Wade Boggs was the first position player to pitch for the Rays. That was in 99. Josh Wilson, Sam Full, Jake Elmore, and Nick Franklin have also pitched. And Taylor Motter's name will be added to that list now. He faces the catcher, James McCann. The pitch is a strike.
Drop down 75. Hank Conger helps him with a little lift there.
1-1. Avila is the runner, and the pitch, a little looper into center field. That will fall for a base hit. Avila's advances to second base. McCann has a 3-hit night.
Right back up the middle, Taylor Motter realizing that ball's gonna drop in and his work will continue. No one wants to make the out here. So you're going to have to work and make some good pitches.
I want to know, that pitch was low to Iglesias. There's the strike. 1-1. Fly ball, short center. Geyer's there to make the catch, and that retires the side. So a third of an inning for Motter. We go to the bottom of the ninth, 10-0 Detroit. ninth inning with Detroit now building a 10-0 lead. Mark Lowe, who has struggled out of the Tiger bullpen, makes his 29th appearance, the third pitcher of the night.
You can see that 28 appearances in, that ERA over 10. It has been a nightmare season for what was going to be their setup guy.
First pitch, Forsythe hits it on the ground and through in the left. Forsythe picks up his first hit of the night for the Rays, hit number three. Jared Saltalamacchia has taken over at first base. Andrew Romine now at second base for Detroit. Brad Miller against Lowe. And a move up, not holding Forsythe, so he moves into second. Strike one on Miller. Mike Aviles has moved over to play left field. Stephen Moy is in right. He started out in right last night. Miller, three ground balls tonight. Kinsler made a very good play on a ball he hit to second in the sixth inning, moving to his right, and a quick flip to first to get him. High fly ball back into left. Avili's all the way to the wall, leaps, and that's going to be out of here, an opposite field home run. And Brad Miller hits his 11th home run to get the Rays on the board, making it 10-2. So the struggles of Mark Lowe continue on the base hit and the home run.
How about that? I mean, that ERA continues to climb. Two swings and misses on the heater. And then this one right here, Brad Miller down and through. And he shows you his strength, because that ball was hit high into the air and still had enough carry to get into that first row all the way out into straight left field.
Well, Tim Beckham is going to hit in the place of Evan Longoria, our pinch a penny pinch hitter. And the pitch is outside. And the Rays with a couple runs on four hits tonight. Again, a three-run ninth for this Detroit ball club after a four-run seventh. Two and one. That's three and one. Morrison on deck. In contrast to this year for Lowe, between the Mariners and the Blue Jays last year, he put together an earned run average of 196. Full count now. Earned run average right now is 10.5. We'll make another 3-2 pitch on Beckham. The Rays, who dropped last night's game 10-7, down 10-2 tonight. And strike three called on Beckham. Out number one in the bottom of the ninth. Logan Morrison, he had a hit in the seventh inning. Rays for the first six had only one hit until Morrison's single with one out in the seventh. 23-year-old right-hander Michael Fulmer was very good again tonight against the Rays. Seven innings of two-hit baseball. There's a strike to Morrison.
Well, his run continues. I mean, five of his last seven starts have been scoreless.
Well, how valuable is that? They got him in the deal with the Mets for Cespedes. He comes over and has blossomed here. After showing promise in the minor leagues, most of that at the double A level, and he had some physical issues, had a knee problem, a shoulder problem, bone spurs in his elbow, but back healthy now. And boy, he is very, very good out there with a three pitch selection. Strike three called on Morrison. So two outs here in the ninth. Brandon Guyer on his way to the plate. Third game of this four-game series tomorrow. Our coverage begins at 3:30. Blake Snell for the Rays against Justin Verlander. The Rays will be looking for their first win of this series after taking two out of three from Boston. Down to their final out tonight, trailing 10-2 in game two of the series against the Tigers. Guyer takes another strike. Two strikes the count. Foul down the right side. Rays are on the board on the home run by Miller. And the 0-2 pitch to Guyer. A little bit wide right there, 1-2. Disappointing night for Drew Smyly. Six runs, four earned, and 6 2/3. Farquhar, Evelyn, Romero, and Taylor Motter followed to the mound. Another pitch close. 2-2. The 2-2 from Long. Skied to center field. Maben is there. And this one is over. 10-14-0 for the Tigers. Eight left. 2-4-2. Three left for the Rays. Fulmer, the winner, 8-2. Smiley, the loser, 2-9. 3 hours and 6 minutes, the time of this game. And the Tigers have taken the first two games of the series. For Brian Anderson, Todd Callis, and the rest of our crew, Dwayne Stats, hope you've enjoyed the telecast. Rays and the Tigers tomorrow. Our coverage begins at 3:30. Now, Rays.